I picked up this rosemary plant on clearance for $1. Let me show you how I revive these distressed plants. I noticed that there are roots coming out of the bottom. I removed these, which made it easier to take this plant out of its container. This rosemary is root bound. There's no more room in the pot for it to grow. I loosened the roots. Don't be afraid to get stuck in there. Plants are tough. By doing this, you will stimulate new growth. Fill up a bucket with water, add seaweed solution to help reduce with transplant shock. Then submerge the rosemary into the bucket. Leave it there until all the bubbles are gone. This means that there's no more air pockets and the root ball is rehydrated. Transfer to a slightly larger pot using good quality potting mix, Fermin and water. Prune any pieces which are dead. Pop back in your label and finally place your rosemary plant in a shaded area for at least 1 week, which will increase the chances of recovery. Did you know that not all bees live in hives? In Australia, 99% of our native bees live alone. That's why it's good to have a bee hotel like this in your garden. It provides them an extra habitat. The raised garden bed area, winter edition. I would say this is the best looking bed out of a lot of them. Some lobelias, and then there's lettuce. These are all leeks along here. Some celery, and at the back there is some bok choy. And all the peas along here are completely gone. They've been eaten, demolished. Look at the state of it. And while I'm showing you that, I might as well show you this bed. This is where all my carrots were. The slugs and snails have devoured them. In this bed, it's full of beetroots. And down here, I come and check it all the time. Look at this. Do you know what that is there? That's purple-topped turnips. This section's only meant to have 4 broccoli plants along here. But you can see it's full of these self-seeded violas. I really need to go and dig these out and transfer them around the garden before they get too much bigger. Did you know if you leave your broccoli on the plant for too long, something pretty cool happens? Each of the individual buds start to open up and turn into flowers, and the bees go crazy for them. They look innocent enough, however, down at the brassica patch, the cabbage moth and cabbage white butterflies are causing havoc, laying their eggs on the plant foliage, which hatch into tiny caterpillars. They don't stay small for long though, munching away in the leaves, so well camouflaged. I need to head down there and remove them by hand before they do any more damage. My friend gave me these cable reels that she had left over from renovating. I'll glue all these together. And with this broken old tub, cut it down to size, just like this. With these random bits and pieces, attach them around the outside. It's now ready to get set up in my garden. Easy to make. I used old chopsticks, these craft letters, and this leftover piece of a tub. A bit of cutting and gluing, a fun upcycle project. Have you ever noticed that plants seem greener after rainfall? One reason for this is because when the rain falls, it brings with it nitrogen from the air. All of the leaves and the roots absorb it. This nitrogen helps the plants to produce chlorophyll, which gives the foliage its green appearance. And we end up with a lush, healthier garden. In a glass, fill it halfway with water, adding 5 drops of food colouring, a little mix. I'm going to place some of these white alyssums in here. Leave this in a sunny spot for 24 hours. After this time, you'll notice that the flowers have changed colour. Here's another one I did with red food dye. And this is how it works. Capillary action and transpiration. What you're looking at is called an air plant. It's not growing in soil or water, but it's very much alive. This one is called Old Man's Beard. It's always disappearing on me though, because the birds take it when they're building their nests. Most of us eat this part of the carrot, which is an enlarged taproot. Or with a broccoli plant, we eat this part here, which is an underdeveloped flower head. But did you know you can also eat this green foliage on the carrots, plus the leaves from the broccoli, And it's stem too. From the garden, I've got this carrot, two spring onions, three stems of this celery, an orange, and finally a lemon. I'll give all of these a wash. Then I'll soak a third of a cup of sultanas in the juice of half an orange for 2 hours. When that's ready, I grate the carrot and chop up its greens, just like this. Next, I chop up the celery and the spring onions, grate 3 orange carrots, chop up half a cup of walnuts and get the zest of the lemon. I've made this delicious Dijon mustard dressing. Then I just put it all together in a bowl. I like to leave in the juice. Give it all a really good mix. It's just such a tasty salad.